All blue eyes.
Mike.
Thanks, Sue. It's time now for some pop music. We are joined this morning by two members of the punk group The Damned. After 10 years in the business, yes, it is 10 years since punk, they're just celebrating their biggest hit so far. It's their version of the song Eloise. It's just reached number 4 in the charts. But of course, their hit was originally made famous back in 1968 when it was sung by Barry Ryan and reached the number 2 spot. So let's just see how those two performances differ. First is the 1986 version of Eloise, sung by The Damned on Top of the Pops.
My Eloise is like the stars that please the night, the sun that makes the day, but lights the way. When that star goes by, I hold it in my hands and cry, her love was mine. You know my sun will shine.
That's what television's all about. It was worth playing that just to see Barry Ryan's face this morning. Have you not seen that for a while?
Not for a while, no.
Did it thrill you tremendously to see it?
No, it's given me a great identity crisis, actually, watching it.
Now, we've got the Damned with us here this morning. Who chose to do Eloise?
Well, it's a song we've wanted to do for a long time. I wanted to do it about 3.5 years ago or so. I wanted to do it for much longer, but it's like an all-time classic. You know?
Well, it was 1968 when it was first a hit.
Mm-hmm.
It would have been sort of through your young teenage years that you would have heard it.
Yeah, it's my young, probably younger than that.
I don't remember it at all. I'm much too young.
But it's a strange, not a strange piece of music, a lovely piece of music, but it's a strange piece of music for a band like you to choose, isn't it?
Not really. I think it was just in character, because the sound of it originally seemed to lend itself to how we would do it, the same sort of spirit, if you like.
But all those strings, that's not punk, is it, really?
Well, we had strings on a Black album, was that 4 or 5 years ago? We had a bit of Scheherazade in the middle of one of our tracks, so...
So do you constantly rake through your mind for old hits that you can redo?
No, it wasn't. I didn't even think of it was a hit or anything. It was just a song that I'd always, liked. There was a few sort of songs that really stuck out from that time, and that was one that seemed... kind of unapproachable if you wanted to do it as a cover, but I thought if anyone's going to do it, we're going to do it first.
Barry,
funnily enough, though, that other one came out at the same time.
Yes, the Far Corporation. There were two versions arrived on the scene at the same
time.
Barry, when did you first hear the Damned's version?
I heard it about 5 or 6 weeks ago.
On the radio, by chance, or did you know it was being done?
I heard it on the radio. I heard this guy's doing an interview on, I think it was Radio 1. And you mentioned that I just have to turn the radio on, and they said they've done Eloise.
Were you surprised?
Yeah, well, it's an old song, but I know what Dave means. It's a definitive sort of 60s pop record, and I think it deserves to be done again as a song in its own right. And I like the version very much that they've done, because it's got the stamp on it, whereas the other version is just a sort of like a copy of mine, which seems a bit pointless, really.
Now, what does it do to you, for instance? Does it make you want, if you can see the fact that can get so high up in the charts, a cover version of your original hit? I mean, does it make you want to get back on the stage and grow the hair a little bit longer and do it all over again?
I don't know. I mean, I weighed about 18 ounces on that film. I mean, it's... I don't know. I mean, I reckon if Nina McCurry can do a comeback, anyone can do a comeback, quite honestly. So, I mean, why not,
And what about for The Damned? Are you perhaps looking for more old songs to do now, or are you going to... Somebody said that you've asked Paul to write some songs, so Paul Ryan.
Well, we're not musical snobs. I mean, if there's a good tune there, we'll have it, mate. No doubt about that. It's if something comes up that's a good, that we like and that we think we can do justice to, then, we'll always give it a go.
But you've actually asked Paul Ryan to come up with some songs for you?
Well, apparently. Well, it was Ryan.
Yeah, it was. He said that Paul had bought a load of synths and things like that and decided he was going to do some more stuff. So he said, well, if he's, let's have an earful before he lets anybody else hear it.
Well, thank you all for coming in this morning. It's a great marrying of all sorts of generations of pop gone through there. And you have got a special concert coming up this year, haven't you? Celebrating your 10 years in the business.
Decade of the Damned,
yeah.
I mean, all the original punks, I presume, are all onto their second children now, aren't they?
Or dead.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Ten years.
Well, no, there's just... it's just over 10 years we've had so many people sort of coming through the ranks. and that, that there's a lot of mates that have now gone on to do much sort of, well, not better things, but gone on to do other things that are sort of good. So we thought it'd be nice if we can get all that together.
Right. On 10 years since punk, and in America they're still treating it like it's only like happened yesterday.
Yeah, it's
amazing,
exactly.
Amazing yeah. stuff. Thank you all very much indeed for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Debbie.
Thanks, Mike. Well, man's inhumanity to man is an old cliche which has lately found new expression in violent crime.
Anyway, I'm going back to Debbie now.